Hey, good day, folks. I welcome you to the city of Livingston, Alabama. I hope you guys are ready to go for a little tour of this city. You guys are also going to get to tour the exterior of the University of Western Alabama.
Continue on North Washington Street for 2 miles.
Let's get to it. Livingston, Alabama is located in Western Alabama in Sumter County. In Sumter County. It is 12 minutes down the street from York, Alabama, which I put out that video yesterday, so feel free to watch it. Now, Livingston is in much better condition than York is in, as you guys will see throughout this video. And 40 minutes west of here will be Meridian, Mississippi. So the population here in Livingston is 3,227 people, and this city has lost 0.6% of its people since 2020. So, you know, this city, you know, it's not really losing nobody. It's, for the most part, the population is stagnant. Let's see. And if you want to live here in Livingston, home prices here are relatively affordable. There's houses for sale for as low as $39,000 if you don't mind doing a little bit of work. Other than that, the median home price here is going to be $127,000, which isn't too shabby. And if you're looking just to rent, your median rent prices are going to go from $650 to $1,140 a month. And let's see. Now, as far as it goes for violent crime, the violent crime is 60% above national average. Your property crime is below national average. As far as it goes for the racial demographics, you got 41.7% white, 46.8% black, and 11.5% Asian. Now, Livingston was incorporated on the 10th of January in 1835, and Livingston is the home of the University of West Alabama. Livingston was named after Edward Livingston, a former American jurist and statesman. He lived from the 28th of May of 1764 to the 23rd of May of 1836. And when Livingston was chosen as a county seat, the city created its first newspaper, the Voice of Sumter, along with four schools to include the Livingston Female Academy, which is now the University of West Alabama. Now, I would say the only negative aspect of living here in Livingston is the fact that, again, it is going to be further away from larger metro areas. However, if you work in occupation to where, I mean, if you do remote work, or if you work maybe in education, you might be able to find a job at the University of West Alabama. But I would say for the most part, when it comes to employment opportunities, there's not gonna be the most amount of opportunities out here due to Livingston itself being a small city. And also due to the fact that this region of Alabama is far from larger metro areas. I mean, the biggest city closest to here is Meridian, Mississippi, which Meridian's only got a population of, I believe, 30 some odd thousand people. So Meridian is not even a metro. But, you know, obviously this is going to be the type of city that if you do remote work and you're looking for a warmer climate that's affordable, to where you can probably find you a house sitting on a large lot. For those of you that have a green thumb and you might want to grow some of your own food, this may not be a bad place to look at and call home. Now, me personally, I mean, although I like this city, I mean, it seems to be a chill out place to live. I personally wouldn't live here because I prefer to live somewhere a little closer to a larger metro area. When I say that, I'm not trying to live in like no Chicago or nothing like that. I'm just saying I prefer to be within an hour of a larger city. Like, if this was within an hour of maybe even Montgomery, Alabama, I would consider it. But given where it's located, I wouldn't consider living here. Now, as you guys will see once we get into the town, I mean, the infrastructure and the condition of this town is not bad. It's definitely a lot better than York. And as far as it goes for your bad neighborhoods or for the hood, I mean, I'm gonna tell you guys, I drove all over this place and I honestly could not locate an area that I would consider bad. Now, there's one little strip which I did drive down, which would be the closest to the resemblance of what some people may consider the hood, which towards the end of the video, I believe, I do drive down that strip. But to be honest, even that area is not bad. I mean, I would say this city, for the most part, it's not a bad place to live. I mean, violent crime is a bit high here. So I would say for those that might want to move here for whatever reason, you might want to go ahead and do your own due diligence on why it is the violent crime here is so high. I mean, maybe there's crimes going on here that clearly I don't know about because I'm not from here. Like when I did my video the other day up to School Me in Alabama, and then I checked the comment section, there was a person who used to live in Tuscumia. I don't think she's there no more, but she used to live there. And this individual told me in the comment section that there were a lot of shootings going on in Tuscumia, Alabama. Which, when I did that video, I said a lot of good things about the city because I thought the city was a nice little city. I clearly had no idea that a lot of shootings went on and a lot of people got eliminated over there. And I guess here, it could be the same situation, I don't know. I mean, hopefully it isn't, but clearly looks can be deceiving. But I would say for the most part, the neighborhoods here do appear to be fairly well kept. I mean, this city, this town, city, whatever you want to call it, definitely looks a lot better than, let's say, Tuskegee, Alabama. I mean, you know, if I had a child that was of college age and they wanted to go to college and they wanted to stay within the state of Alabama, I mean, I would feel a lot more comfortable with them going to this college as opposed to going to college in Tuskegee. Alright folks, that's all I got for the commentary. I don't really have a whole lot to say on this one. So you guys know what to do. So on that note, you guys have a blessed one and I'll see you on the next one.